A group of people from Sabalat, Oman, came up with an idea of presenting His Majesty Sultan Qaboos, the world's largest portrait mosaic in a single piece on his 40th accession day. Bramco had done the mosaic works at the Grand Mosque, for which they even won an international award from the Marble Institute of America, a Prism Award for the mosaic works. And Bramco is nominated by the Dewan for doing all the works for His Majesty Sultan Qaboos. And therefore, the obvious choice was Bramco. The team came to meet me and said that it's a challenging task to make this mosaic. We've just come up with the idea. We wanted to use only stones and rocks and pebbles available from Oman. So we asked Car Design to assist us and help us doing the concept, choosing the right stone.
We were making the greatest mosaic in the world for one of the greatest leaders in the Middle East in the shortest time period ever.
Various stones were selected by Car Design in various quarries, and we went to Ibri to choose a pink stone from the Ibri quarry, and then Ibra to choose the beige stone. And then it was a difficult task of choosing some very specific colors, and we found them on the beaches of Kuryat. In Kuryat beach there are pebbles, sea pebbles, and these are different colors like agates or parts you can find here. And the eyes and things were found from there.
Each part of our skin has different tonal variations. Each part of our face has different tonal variations, and I wanted that represented in the stone. Each stone is different. I wanted to use 30 different shades from the legal beige block. That means 50 different slabs, different parts of the slab to then be incorporated perhaps in 5 single lines of mosaic, so that the 3-dimensional life-size image would come through. We made an amazing discovery. There was quartz in the regal bed, which was perfect. It was as if it was actually meant to be, because the turban itself had white as well as red from the portrait.
Most of the stones came from Oman, and the white beard, which is with grey streaks, had to be specially flown in from Italy. It's white Sagittario, and it's just a coincidence that this is one of his most favourite stones for His Majesty. All his palaces, most of his palaces have white Sagittario on the floor. We took this opportunity of getting the white Sagittario, putting a little bit of Italy into this Oman mosaic.
My representative was then told to select anything that would match those 30 different colors of each sample shade and get the blocks out of the quarry and have them laid out for me to then further select.
His Majesty's private photographer gave us a set of pictures to look at, and we were presented, and the whole committee, we were sitting together in a friendly way and seeing which picture would represent the right mood, the right character, which would radiate what His Majesty Sultan Qaboos is about. And we came out with this very simple picture where he was in his beige dishdash standing in the desert with his stick, without any ornaments or without any glamour, jewelry and nothing. And that to me was the right picture, because it projected simplicity, and His Majesty is known for his simplicity. The whole team went and they drew lots of drawings, and so complicated at one stage my chief artisan Javed and Maqbool, these two guys, they said, "Oh, it's not possible, it's not possible, it's too much, it's too much." And we said, "No, it's for His Majesty, we got to do it. Oh, it will take 1 year." "No, no, 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 I want it done now. And we have only 60 days to do it." And they were going for a passion that they were making the face of His Majesty the mosaic with our own hands. And no, you know, they were all hand shaped. A typical traditional way of doing mosaic, not a mechanical way where you cut parallels and squares and then just put them together. Each piece has been broken by hand. The most important feature of the mosaic was the face. So that took the longest, and we could not put every artist or artisan on the face. So we had five of our best selected artisans who undertook the job of the face. And you'll be surprised, even though the whole mosaic took 100 odd days, the face alone took 40 days.
It wouldn't have been possible without Yusuf, the artist's amazing collaboration and eye for detail. He came over every stage, at every stage as we moved from turban to face to background to feet. He came over to select each piece, collaborate on the individual piece selection and placement of all the pieces.
Total, you can say we put in about more than 4,500 man hours to do the job. Everybody was very excited, and it was just like a thing. Everybody wanted to come and see it here, how it's happening. And we kept it closed in the factory. We didn't want others to come and see what we are doing. We wanted like a surprise. Because the mosaic is 9 meters high, we had to erect the stands, and proper structural and strand work was done. Do you believe that 128,000 pieces of different colors from different places have been stitched together to get this mosaic? And it's going to be a world record for a single portrait mosaic, and I'm sure we're not going to produce one bigger than this, and I'm also sure that nobody else can do the same. And it would have been as the biggest mosaic for quite some time. We'll be right back.